Welcome to the Academy, a series focused on the basics of Star Wars The Old Republic.
If you've just gotten into artifice crafting in Star Wars The Old Republic, you may have realized there's an incredible amount of material types available that you need to craft all the different types of items that artifice has to offer. In this video, we'll be going over the many different ways to get a hold of the artifice crafting materials needed, including color crystals, power crystals, and artifact fragments from archaeology, and gemstones from treasure hunting. An important thing to know about crafting materials is that they don't go into your inventory most of the time. Instead, they automatically go into a special type of bank called your materials bay. This materials bay is shared by all your characters on your server, and anything you craft will automatically pull from your materials bay supply. You may have even already earned some crafting materials while you were playing that went straight to your crafting bay. If you have artifice and you haven't already picked up archaeology and treasure hunting as your two complementary skills, you'll want to head to the fleet and go to the strongholds and crew skills section and talk to the archaeology and treasure hunting trainers. Once you pick those up, the next step is to figure out what it is you want to craft. You can press B to open your crafting panel and find the schematic you want to craft in your artifice crew skill. This will show you the materials that you need to get. Roll over the material with your mouse and it will tell you what type of material it is. For example, is it a grade 1 power crystal, a grade 1 artifact, or something else? For artifice, pretty much all color crystals, power crystals, and artifact fragments will come from archaeology. The gemstones will instead come from treasure hunting. So we're going to start off with the archaeology missions. So the most common way to get materials is to send your companions out on crew skills missions. If you're just starting archaeology, the gathering skill, you'll notice there's only two missions available. It'll give you grade 1 power crystals and artifact fragments, and you can send each of your companions out on those. As you do more gathering with archaeology, more missions will become unlocked. In addition, the higher your archaeology level, which you level up by missions or by gathering materials in the open world, higher grades of materials will also become unlocked. So here's a quick chart of at what point at archaeology those different grades become available. Your companion's influence level affects a lot of the crafting activities. A companion with a high influence level can craft and gather faster, have a chance of crafting double items or augmented items, and a better chance of succeeding and bringing back a better reward from gathering missions like underworld trading and archaeology. To learn more about raising your companion's influence, check out my companion gift guide video. Treasure hunting works almost exactly the same. The big difference is that treasure hunting has multiple different types of rewards, and not all of them are useful specifically for artifice. The types of missions that give you materials for artifice are the ones that have gemstone under them. White bordered materials are a little bit different. You can either send your companion to gather them if you have a mission available for them, or buy them directly from a vendor called the Crew Skills Trade Vendor in the Strongholds and Crew Skills section of the fleet, who sells them pretty cheap. In addition to getting crafting materials from sending your companions out on crew skill missions with archaeology, you'll also be able to pick up crystals and artifacts you find on the ground in the open world by right-clicking them. The higher your archaeology level is, the more materials you'll get, so you can gather high-level materials, but you won't get very many. Here's an easy list of worlds where you can find color crystals, power crystals, and artifact fragments materials to gather for free. You can spot materials on the open world by looking for the star symbol on your minimap or big map in the small radius around you, or by watching out for colorful crystal formations and archaeological artifacts with blue glowing text near them. You can right-click these to send your companion after them. I was originally looking into making some maps of all the different gathering nodes out in the open world, but to be honest, just head to the correct planet, get out of the starter area, zoom out your mini-map with your scroll button, and start looking around for those stars. They're usually pretty plentiful. Not all items can be gathered from the open world. Your second related gathering skill, treasure hunting and gemstones, will only allow you to gather materials by sending your companions out on missions. You'll never find a treasure hunting material out in the open world. Crafting materials can also be bought and sold on the GTN. To buy materials from other players, you can go to the fleet and go to the Galactic Trade Market section of the map. Once there, right-click the big green terminal and then click in the search box. If you're looking for a specific material and aren't having luck with your crew skill missions, or want to get a hold of the materials quicker, you can type the name of the crafting material into the GTN, click search, then sort by price lowest to highest. Even better, if you have the schematic window also open, click into the search box and shift left click on the material to automatically put the name of the material into the GTN search box. Nice. If you want to make some easy credits, you can sell any materials you aren't using on the GTN to other players who are crafting. Just remember to set the sell price to the number of materials you are selling times the price you want to sell them each at. To take crafting materials out of your materials bay to sell, open your materials bay and right-click the item. It'll go into your inventory. To split a pile of materials or any other item, shift right-click the pile and type in how many you want to separate out. For normal crafting materials, like what you get from archaeology, players usually want to buy them in piles rather than one by one. Jawa scraps are a type of currency that you can turn in for crafting materials. There are three types of this Jawa scrap currency. Green, which is called scavenge scrap, blue, which is called assorted droid parts, and purple, which is called Jawa junk, which is also what players often call this type of currency. Jawa scraps can come from many different sources, but the most common is by completing your conquest goal for the week. Almost all basic crafting materials can be bought with Jawa scrap, and each type of material costs different amounts. To spend your Jawa scrap, head to the fleet and go to the Cartel Bazaar, which is the Northern Elevator Republic side and the Southern Elevator Imperial side. There you'll find a group of Jawa vendors who will sell you materials for scrap. Turning scrap into materials and then selling the materials is also a great easy way to make credits. If you need a list of all the artifice and treasure hunting materials you can get from the Jawa vendors and how much they cost, visit the written version of this guide and skip to the how to get materials section. Lastly, you can also get a special type of decoration from Conquest that is like an open world gathering node, but you can place it down in your stronghold, and you can gather from a few of them every 4 hours or so. Some of these decorations reward specific materials, while others can give you a variety of materials in a certain gathering skill. All Conquest crafting decorations can be bought and sold on the GTN. Those are all the different ways you can get specific materials based on what schematic you want to craft, but there's also tons of ways to get different randomized materials. Crafting materials are rewards for lots of different quests and loot boxes around the galaxy. I hope this video helped you cover all the different ways that you can get the materials that you need for your artifice crafting. If you're just getting started with artifice crafting, you might also want to go check out my other video, The Artifice Crafting Guide. If you want to show your support for this series and support these guides, visit sutterista.com/support. And if you want to have similar Star Wars The Old Republic videos show up on your YouTube homepage, subscribe to this channel. As always, may the Force be with you.